Hello, I'm Mr. R. Lidger, a retired lecturer in Mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm going to differentiate between disciples and laborers. Whether Jesus had disciples or laborers. Now, these two terms are used in Christianity. In the New Testament, so in the beginning, when Jesus had the 12, he picked them up, not that everybody could join him, he picked them that you come, not that anybody who wanted to join could join it. So those pick was special one, and Judah Iscariot got himself picked for his knowledge of 3 hours. Jesus did not pick him up. So, when you go around to do certain job or in the house you want something done, then you pick a carpenter or a laborer or whatever you want to do of your own choice. Not that everybody can come, I can do it, let me do it. So, the laborers should be sensible. Otherwise, they can do wrong things. The disciples are those who obey what their master tells them to do. Like in the under rabbinic system, they had disciples. John the Baptist and earlier Rabbi, he had disciples. So the people who are under him, are they under the Rabbi, whatever Rabbi tells them, they just follow it to the very letters. If he tells them not to do anything without his permission, they won't do it. And this is the rabbinic laws, that the Rabbi, he is all in all, in the synagogue and in his congregation. So on Sabbath, which is have been a seventh day, which is devoted to God. So when it's devoted to God, then you should not do any secular work. You should devote your spiritual work, which is philanthropy. Doing good to the others. So when the rabbis, they were alive, spiritually alive, not spiritually dead, as when Christ Jesus came, they were spiritually dead, then they were leading the people to the right direction. So on Sabbath, they will go around performing philanthropic work for the others, who could not do it, like old people, helping them, feeding them, and all that. So if it is done like that, then you have a very healthy society where you can live like heaven, peaceful. But as this dark age is, so the rabbis had become corrupt, so they could not lead the people, so people were left in the lurch. So this is what happens these days, that the rabbi themselves, they are not spiritual, they are dead in spirit. So Christ Jesus came to fulfill the law. In the fulfillment of the law, you need to go by the written Torah, which is scripture, and the oral Torah. Oral Torah is his word. And this knowledge of oral Torah was missing among the rabbinic rabbis and their Pharisee and Sadducee. That's why when Jesus was 12, he went to the temple and over there to the rabbis and Pharisee and Sadducees, he explained written Torah in spiritual terms, giving them the inside out of the written Torah, why it is so and why it is written so, why you do like this, why not do like that. So he gave them all the basis of that written Torah. That is what those Pharisee doctors of law at the temple, they were astonished at his wisdom, that this boy of 12 could explain so many things. So that is the, when the rabbis, they had this knowledge, then the people, they just followed them blindly. And they were disciples, whatever the rabbis will tell them, they will do it, and it was done for the their benefits. But when these people, rabbis, became dead in spirit, and so the people, so much so, that on Sabbath, these people sit down in their house, and if somebody visits them on Sabbath, they are not allowed even to light the cooker. So will they, a friend of mine just told me that is, he lived next to a Jew, so on Sabbath day somebody visited him, he wanted to give them a cup of tea, so he went for me to invite me to come and light the cooker, and if you can please make the tea for them. So this is how it is dead, you know. That if on Sabbath, that is what Jesus said, on Sabbath, if an animal falls into a pit, won't you take him out or leave it to die? That means use common sense. And common sense is the Holy Spirit. So there's so much so blindness in them that when it's a Sabbath, a holy day, and you are supposed to do holy works, and Christ Jesus, when he was doing healing on Sabbath, which is the rightful work to do on Sabbath, these dead to spirit people were just looking at him. Let him do it and we will object to him. So you can see how spiritually dead those people were. And so much is spiritually dead that in London, somebody house caught fire on Sabbath. Instead of putting it off, they rang the rabbi, tell us what to do. He said, oh, call the fire brigade. By the time they called fire brigade, two more houses got burned. And I happened to mention this thing at our interfaith meeting in Reading. And over there, Rabbi tell me this, so in Jerusalem also it's happening like this, that the houses are getting burnt and they are calling their rabbi, not using their common sense. So this is how they were dead in this one. So normally these laws, they were meant for children. So intake of the law is children. That's why these rabbis are those teachers, they are called schoolmasters. And scripture is milk on which they are fed. So the children will have to obey what their teacher tells them. Otherwise they can do something wrong of their own. That's why in schools when you go, you don't allow children to do whatever they like to do. It's always the teacher who instructs them, do this way, do that way. If he does anything of his own, then he is punished. Same was in the Jewish system. So when the people were doing anything of their own, they were punished. And the rabbis will give them a good sentence. So these teachers being have to be responsible, they are only of certain tribes, and in the Middle East it is of Levite tribe, while in India we have Brahmins of quite a few tribes. Outside those tribes, nobody could become a Brahmin.